There are many gene banks for crops around the world, and these gene banks have held interest for use of the world, some of the main and important crop varieties and their wide relatives. We have no such facility for livestock, even though the germplasm, the natural resources, but the biodiversity of livestock are being eroded in the same way as crop varieties are being eroded. So we're trying to think through how this might be done. The World Food and Agriculture Organization held a very important meeting, and they considered this matter, found it very important, and made a number of recommendations about how this might be done. So we're trying to pick up on those recommendations and to see how we might apply these to safeguard the heritage of livestock species as well. The whole idea is not to preserve everything, but to preserve that which is most threatened, and to look for ways by which this should be done. Should we be putting semen and ova in cryopreservation, cold storage, or can we maintain this in situ where these rare breeds are, or should we have a central place where you can collect some of these rare breeds in what is referred to as in situ live preservation? We're studying this matter, and we're trying to come up with the cheapest, more effective proposals by which we can work with other partners. The short-term benefit is that we would hopefully reduce the amount of loss in biodiversity that we know is taking place, that we will have these animals safe, and we can use them in the future. The long-term benefit is that, of course, just as with crops, we're depending on the challenges you face, resistance for diseases, resistance to climate, and so on, we will be able to reach into these gene pools, which might have those characteristics to deal with the challenges as they come up over time. So the long-term benefit is having the wherewithal, the opportunity to search within the indigenous populations for future adaptabilities and other challenges that we would want to deal with.